Hi guys, welcome back to math class with Miss Brown. In today's class, we will be subtracting integers, okay? So take a look at the top of the board. We have all of the rules that we are going to be working on today. I know that seems like a lot. It is, right? But we're going to go through each rule step by step, and I'm going to model for you guys, okay, how we solve with each rule. So the first rule we have is a positive minus a positive, and it will give me a positive. So this is just basic subtraction, right? So a positive number, so let's say 7 minus 3, right? Two basic numbers, right? 7 minus 3, basic subtraction, right? We could have the positive symbols there or not. It doesn't matter, okay? It is still positive numbers. So 7 minus 3 is 4. That's it. Basic subtraction. That's a positive minus a positive, which gave us a positive. That's it. So I'm also going to show you how to do a positive minus a positive that gives us a negative, right? So we know when we subtract, right, we know that we have our big number first and we subtract the smaller number. But in some cases, we would have a smaller number and we would have to subtract a bigger number. But we say to ourselves, well, how could you do that? You can't take away a big number from a small number. So let's take a look. 3 minus 7. Can we do 3 minus 7? Right? No, we really technically can't. You say to yourself, if I have 3, I can't take away 7. So this is how we're going to get our negative answer, right? So just think of if you flip the numbers, right? Flip it in your brain. So if we do 7 minus 3, 7 minus 3 will give me 4, right? So that 4 is going to turn into a negative because we can't do 3 minus 7, but we know 7 minus 3 is 4, but we just add the negative symbol to our answer. Or the other way we can do it is, what we can do is we can change the operation, right? Well, what do you mean by that, Miss Brown? Well, I'm going to change that subtraction symbol to a positive symbol. But once I change my operation, that means I have to change the symbol to the number that's after the operation. So we originally had a positive 7, so I have to change that into a negative 7. And if you know anything about adding integers, you can't add a positive with a negative. So you really have to subtract in your brain. So 7 minus 3 is 4, and then you take the symbol to the biggest absolute value, and the biggest absolute value was a 7, right? And that was a negative, so that's why our answer became a negative 4. So let's try another one, okay? Let's try another one before we move on, okay? Because I know that sounds a little confusing, okay? So let's try another one. So let's do 2 minus 8. Right? And it's going to give us a negative number, right? Can we do 2 minus 8? No, we can't take away a big number from a small number. But let's flip the numbers in our head and do it that way. 8 minus 2 is 6. So we're just going to throw that negative symbol onto the 6, okay? All right, or you can do it the other way by changing the subtraction symbol into a positive, and then you have to change the symbol to the number after the operation. So that 8 was a positive 8, so we changed it to a negative 8. And if you know anything about adding integers, you can't add a positive with a negative, right? So you have to subtract in your brain. 8 minus 2 is 6, right? And then you take the symbol from the biggest absolute value, and the biggest absolute value is 8. So that's why we took the negative symbol from the 8, and that's how we got negative 6. So I know that sounds like a lot, right? I know. That's a lot of rules to remember, right? So let's do the next one. We have a negative minus a negative, which will give us a positive number, right? So just watch step by step as I model, okay? So let's do negative 7 minus negative 3, right? So that's a negative minus a negative, right? A negative number minus a negative number. So just ask yourself, what is 7 minus 3, right? Both of the numbers have a negative symbol. So this is going to be easy. 7 minus 3 is 4, and then bring that negative symbol over, and that's how we get negative 4, right? Because both of the numbers have a negative symbol, right? That's it. So easy, right? Yeah. So let's do another one. Let's do negative 8 minus, let's say, negative 2, right? So both of the numbers have a negative symbol. So ask yourself, can you do 8 minus 2? The answer is yes. 8 minus 2 is 6, and bring that negative symbol over. The answer is negative 6, okay? Super easy, right? So some rules are easy and some rules are a little bit confusing, right? Okay, so now let's do a negative minus a negative that will give us a positive, right? Remember, we just did a negative minus a negative that gave us a negative. So now we're going to do a negative minus a negative that will give us a positive, okay? All right, I know it's a lot of rules, but just stick with me here, okay? So let's do negative 3 minus negative 7, right? And this is going to give us a positive. So take a look. We have a 3 minus a 7. Can you do that? The answer is no, right? Okay, so what you'll do is, if you know you can't take the bigger number away from the smaller number, you're going to change the operation. We're going to change that operation from a subtraction to an addition. Once we change that operation, that means we have to change the symbol to the number that's after the operation. So we have a negative 7, that has to change to a positive 7, right? So now we have a negative number plus a positive number. If you know anything about adding negatives and positives, you know that we can't do that. So we're going to subtract in our head. 7 minus 3 is 4. Take the symbol to the highest or the biggest absolute value. The biggest absolute value is the 7, and that's a positive number. So that's why my answer is going to remain a positive 4. Okay, I hope that makes sense. I hope it does. All right, let's do another one. Let's do negative 5 minus negative, negative 11. Yes, can we do 5 minus 11? Nope, we can't do that. So now you know we have to change our operation. We're going to change our operation from a subtraction symbol to an addition symbol, right? So let's change that to an addition symbol. Being that I changed my operation, I have to change the symbol to the number after the operation. So we went from a negative 11 to a positive 11. So 11 minus 5 is 6. Take the symbol to the highest or the biggest absolute value, which is 11. That's a positive number. So that's why my answer remains a positive 6. Does that make sense, guys? If it doesn't, just rewatch the video, and the more practice, the better you guys will become. So the next rule is a positive minus a negative. That will give us a positive, right? Oh my God, it's a lot of rules. I know. So a positive minus a negative equals a positive. So let's get started, okay? So let's do 7 minus negative 4. Yeah, let's do negative 4, okay? All right, 7 minus negative 4, okay? Can we do 7 minus 4? The answer is yes. But remember, both of our numbers have different integers, right? So we have a positive integer and we have a negative integer, right? So we can't do that. So that means we have to change our symbol. We're going to change our operation symbol from a subtraction to an addition. And remember, when you change your operation symbol, you also have to change your integer to the number that's also after your operation symbol. Now we have two positive numbers. 7 plus 4 is 11. So that's how we got positive 11. Oh my God, I hope this makes a lot of sense to you guys. Let's try another one because I know that is a lot. I know. So let's do 3 minus negative 7, okay? 3 minus negative 7, right? So remember, we can't subtract a big number from a small number. We can't do 3 minus 7. So that's going to make us change our operation symbol. We're going to change that from subtraction to addition. Once we do that, we have to change the integer symbol to the number after that, right? So now we got both positive numbers, 3 plus 7, which is 10, okay? 3 plus 7 is 10, okay? So yeah, so that's how we subtract a positive with the negative to get a positive, okay? I know that's a lot, but remember, the more practice you guys will do, the better you will become. You will become better, okay? So please don't get discouraged, okay? Don't get discouraged. It's okay. You guys will get the hang of it once you start doing it a lot, okay? Let's do another one. Let's do 10 minus, 5. Let's do 10 minus negative 5. I'm sorry. Okay. So, okay, we can do 10 minus 5, but both of the numbers have different integers. We have a positive and a negative. So that means we have to change our operation symbol. I'm going to change it from a subtraction to an addition. Okay. So I'm going to change the subtraction symbol to an addition symbol. So once I do that, I also have to change the integer to the digit that's after. Okay. So now we have two positives. 10 plus 5 is 15. And that's how we got 15. I hope that makes a lot of sense, guys. I really do. All right. So it looks like the next rule we have up at the top is a negative minus a positive. And this time, this will give me a negative. Remember, we just did a positive minus a negative that gave us a positive. So now we're going to do a negative minus a positive that will give us a negative. Yes, so let's get right into it. This is the last rule. Okay, so let's do a negative 3 minus 7. Okay, can we do 3 minus 7? Nope, the answer is no, but both numbers have different integers. We have a negative one and a positive one. So we have to change my operation symbol from a subtraction to an addition. Change the integer of the number that's after the operation. So we had a positive 7, so that's why I had to change it to a negative 7. So now we can add a negative 3 plus negative 7. That's easy. We get negative 10. That's it, right? So like I said before, some of the rules are just like easy, right? And then some of them are confusing, and that it's okay. Like I said before, the more you guys do this, it will become more familiar to you guys. So let's do negative 6 minus 6. Yeah, let's do that. Okay, so we have two of the same numbers, right? But they have different integers. Have to change our operation to an addition, change our integer to the digit after that from a positive to a negative. So negative 6 plus negative 6 is negative 12. That's so easy. Yeah, that's how we got negative 12. I know this is a lot of rules for you guys to remember, but I promise you, the more you keep doing this and the more you practice, you will get better, okay? So don't get discouraged. But I will see you guys in the next class, okay? Bye.